sarvabhuteshu navesheshyosti na priyaha ye bhajanti tumam bhaktya maite te shyamyam.
I envy no one, nor am I partial to anyone. I am equal to all, but whoever renders service unto me in devotion is a friend, is in me, and I am also a friend to him.
Satya Yuga, during the reign of the sixth Manu, Chakshusha Manu, and they were brothers, born from the wives of Kashyapa Muni, and yet they fought. Meet the Devas, also known as the Adityas, sons of Aditi with Kashyapa Muni. Indra, king of the Devas. Chandra, the moon god. Surya, the sun god.
Agni, the
fire god. Vayu, the wind god. Varuna, god of the waters. Meet the asuras, also known as the daityas and danavas, sons of Diti and Danu with Kashyapa Muni.
Bali, king of the asuras.
Rahu,
Muchi,
Paka,
Jambasura,
and Kalanemi.
The Devas' tragic defeat was the result of Durvasa Muni's curse. Once, when the yogi was strolling along a road, he saw Indra riding on the back of his elephant. Durvasa offered his flower garland to Indra. However, instead of placing it over his own neck, Indra hung it on the trunk of his elephant.
Being an animal,
the elephant threw the wreath between his feet and stomped on it. Highly offended by Indra's pride and carelessness, Durvasa bellowed a curse. May you lose all your opulence. It was because of Indra's ensuing poverty that the Asuras were able to so easily defeat the demigods.
They have the Sanjeevani mantra. Of course they won. My Lord Indra, what shall we do?
We will go to Lord Brahma.
Surely he will help us.
Thus, all the devas, including Lord Shiva, assembled and traveled to the peak of Sumeru Mountain to appeal to Lord Brahma.
Tamaham Bhajami. My dear Lord Brahma, we have lost all of our wealth and power.
The Asuras have defeated us and taken control of the universe.
My Lord, we do not have the power to reclaim our kingdom.
Please help us.
Yes, Lord Brahma. For the sake of the entire universe, please help the Devas regain their former position.
The Asuras are selfish. If they rule the universe, all the living entities will be in a distressed condition. Govindam Adipurusham Tamoham Bhajam.
Lord Vishnu, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, will surely help you, my dear Devas. He is equal to all, but for the sake of managing the universal affairs and to protect his devotees, he appears in various avatars to deliver them. Come, let's go to the island of Shweta Dvipa.
Kamala Priya, Kamale Kanda.
My Lord, we the various demigods, the directors of this universe, have come to your lotus feet. Please fulfill the purpose for which you have come. You are the witness of everything, from within and without. Nothing is unknown to you, and therefore it is unnecessary to inform you of anything. My Lord, please deliver the demigods from their predicament. O Lord Brahma, Lord Shiva, and other demigods, please hear me with great attention, for what I say will bring good fortune for all of you. As long as you are not flourishing, you should make a truce with the demons and asuras, who are now being favored by time. Immediately endeavor to produce nectar, which a person who is about to die may drink to become immortal. O demigods, cast into the ocean of milk all kinds of vegetables, grass, creepers, and drugs. Then, with my help, making Mandara Mountain the churning rod and Vasuki the rope for churning, churn the ocean of milk with one pointed attention. Thus, the demons will be engaged in labor, but you, the demigods, will gain the actual result, the nectar produced from the ocean.
Sarvabhuteshu Namethyoshti Napriyata Ye Bhajanti Tumam Bhatya Maite Te Chapyadam.
I envy no one, nor am I partial to anyone. I am equal to all. But whoever renders service unto me in devotion is a friend, is in me, and I am also a friend to him.
My dear demigods, with patience and peace, everything can be done. But if one is agitated by anger, the goal is not achieved. Therefore, whatever the demons ask, agree to their proposal. A poison known as Kalakuta will be generated from the ocean of milk, but you should not fear it, and when various products are churned from the ocean, you should not be greedy for them or anxious to obtain them. Nor should you be angry.
All the Devas then went to Tripura, the abode of King Bali, the demon leader. Since Bali had conquered the universe, his palace was extraordinarily opulent. The gods approached his throne in a peaceful manner, offering him proper respects. But his assistant demons suspected their brothers, the Devas, of mischief.
What do you want here?
My dear brothers.
Brothers? They called us brothers?
Please hear me. We've come on a peace mission.
Peace? Oh, sure.
Please believe us.
I say we kill them. Finish the job we started.
Let's first hear their proposal. Proceed.
We would like you to help us churn the ocean of milk.
For what purpose?
To obtain nectar from it and become immortal.
Nectar?
Yes.
What makes you so sure it's there?
Because Vishnu told me it is.
So why do you need our help?
Because a tremendous amount of manpower will be needed.
But then who will keep the nectar?
we will share it.
That sounds fair. Then let's do it.
Having declared a truce, the Devas and Asuras set out confidently to lift Mandara Mountain. The Lord very easily lifted the mountain with one hand and placed it on the back of Garuda. Then he too got on the back of Garuda and went to the ocean of milk, surrounded by the demigods and demons.
My dear Garuda, please leave this place. The Devas and Asuras will now summon the great serpent Vasuki. If you are here, he will not come.
Yes, my lord.
Call forth Vasuki from the nether world.
You please become our rope by wrapping yourself around the Mandara Mountain.
And then, by taking hold of you and churning the ocean of milk, we can obtain the nectar of immortality.
So, you'll pull me and yank me from side to side? Why should I do this? What's in it for me?
We'll give you a share of the nectar.
I see. Okay, I agree.
Sari, 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 sari. Thank you.
don't want to hold the rear end of the snake and bring bad luck.
Yeah, we want the head.
Yeah, the good luck side.
Demigods and demons resumed their positions and with renewed hope began to churn the mountain energetically. As Mount Mandara rotated back and forth on Kurma's shell, the Lord felt the pleasurable sensation one feels when one's itchy back is vigorously scratched. He also continued to infuse the men with an ever-increasing quantity of strength. Then, atop the swiveling mountain, he manifested another incredible form. This one with thousands of arms and sat there cross-legged, keeping Mandara firmly balanced with one of his hands. Was so intensely agitated that all the creatures living in it, alligators, fish, sharks, tortoises, whales, etc., became fearfully perturbed. But this did not hinder the devas and asuras' enthusiasm until Vasuki began emitting choking smoke and blazing fire from his thousands of mouths. Gradually, the smoke afflicted them and diminished their strength.
Seeing their pathetic condition, the Lord immediately produced billows of rain clouds in the sky. Torrents of rain fell and gusty winds blew, bringing the men much relief. Soon, the Lord himself joined their endeavors. Grabbing Vasuki, he began churning the milk vigorously. As he worked, he himself looked like a magnificent mountain. But then, something terrible happened. The first substance that rose to the surface of the ocean was not nectar at all. It was poison, and it spread all over the sea. It was extremely dangerous.
What is this?
Poison, my lord! It's poison!
This poison is going to kill us!
Move away!
It's coming towards us!
My lord, what shall we do?
My dear devotees, let us go to Lord Shiva in his abode and Mount Kailash. This poison is a mere drop for him. Humbly beseech him, and he will surely dissipate and eradicate this great danger.
Shankara Nada Shariva Para Veda Vihara Jiveshwara Shankara Nada Sharira Para Veda Vihara Para Jiveshwara Shankara
Ganga, 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 Gan
Shiva Shambho Swayambho Ho Shambho 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 Shiva Shambho Swayambho Gangadhara Shankara Karunakara Mamava Bhava Sagara Taraka Gangadhara Shankara Karunakara Mamava Bhava Sagara Taraka
Shiva, even personalities like Lord Brahma and other demigods cannot understand your position, for you are beyond the material creation. Since no one can understand you in truth, how can one offer you prayers? It is impossible.
We are creatures of Lord Brahma's creation. Under the circumstances, therefore, we can't offer you adequate praise. But as far as our ability allows, we have expressed our feelings.
O greatest of all rulers, your actual identity is impossible for us to understand. As far as we can see, your presence brings flourishing happiness to everyone. Beyond this, no one can appreciate your activities. We can see this much and nothing more.
Please, dear Lord, save us from the terrible poison, Hala Hala, which is quickly enveloping the universe.
My dear Bhavani, just see how all these living entities have been placed in danger because of the poison produced from the churning of the ocean of love. It is my duty to give protection and safety to all living entities struggling for existence.
Yes, my lord. Certainly, it is the duty of the master to protect his suffering dependents.
My dear gentle wife Bhavani, when one is kind to others, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Hari, is very pleased. And when the Lord is pleased, I am also pleased, along with all other living creatures. Therefore, let me drink this poison for all the living entities may thus become happy because of me.
Dhimita, dhimita, dhimi, dhimi, kita, kita, to. Tom, tom, tari, kita, kita, to. Dhimita, dhimita, dhimi, dhimi, kita, kita, to.
To please the Supreme Lord, and out of compassion for the suffering living entities, Lord Shiva voluntarily suffered himself to drink the poison. By his mystic power, he caused the poison to rise from the ocean and, like an undulating snake, slither towards his outstretched palm. Scorpions, cobras, poisonous drugs, and other animals whose bites are poisonous took the opportunity to drink whatever little poison had fallen and scattered from Lord Shiva's hand while he was drinking. As if in defamation, the poison manifested its potency by marking Lord Shiva's neck with a bluish line. That line, however, is now accepted as an ornament of the Lord. Upon Lord Shiva's drinking the poison, both the demigods and the demons, being very pleased, began to churn the ocean with renewed vigor. As a result of this, there appeared a cow known as Surabhi. Great sages, who were completely aware of the Vedic ritualistic ceremonies, took charge of that Surabhi cow. Thereafter, a horse named Ucheshrava, which was as white as the moon, was generated. Bali Maharaj desired to possess this horse, and Indra, the king of heaven, did not protest, for he had previously been so advised by the Supreme Personality of Godhead. As the next result of the churning, the king of elephants named Airavata was generated. This elephant was white, and with its four tusks, it defied the glories of Kailash Mountain, the glorious abode of Lord Shiva. Lord Indra claimed this elephant as his mount.
After this, 16 more elephants were generated. Generated thereafter from the great ocean were the celebrated gems Kaustubha Mani and Padmaraga Mani. Lord Vishnu, to decorate his chest, desired to possess them. Generated next was the Parijatha flower, which decorates the celestial planets.
Next, there appeared the Apsaras. They were fully decorated with golden ornaments and lockets, and were dressed in fine and attractive clothing. The Apsaras move very slowly in an attractive style that bewilders the inhabitants of the heavenly planets.
The goddess of fortune, Rama, who is absolutely dedicated to being enjoyed by the Supreme Personality of Godhead. She appeared like electricity, surpassing the lightning that might illuminate a marble mountain. Because of her exquisite beauty, her bodily features, her youth, her complexion, and her glories, everyone desired her. They were attracted because she is the source of all opulences.
What a beauty!
What a perfect form!
Is she married? Maybe she'll marry me.
She is the goddess of all goddesses.
Like Lakshmi herself.
Someone who is naturally endowed with all good qualities and devoid of faults. Only he can be my husband. No one else. He has undergone great austerity, but has not yet conquered anger. He is a very great personality, but he cannot conquer lusty desire. All of these great personalities depend on others for their protection. Where is the Supreme Controller? Only he can be my husband.
The unconquerable.
Brahma, my beloved consort.
Vishnu is the only enjoyer of Lakshmi, as revealed in the Bhagavad Gita 5:29. Realizing this, the devas felt peace, and by Rama's favorable glance, they were immediately enriched with good behavior and transcendental qualities. Thus they were very much satisfied. The demons, however, being neglected by the goddess of fortune, became depressed, bewildered, and frustrated, and thus they became shameless.
Appeared Varuni, the lotus-eyed goddess who controls drunkards. With the permission of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, the demon, headed by Bali Maharaj, took possession of this young girl. While the sons of Kashyapa, both demons and demigods, were engaged in churning the ocean of milk, a very wonderful godly person appeared. Especially conversant in medical science, he was handsome, well-built, strong, adorned with ornaments, and well-dressed. He was Dhanvantari, a partial incarnation of the Lord. In one of his hands, he carried a golden jug.
What's in the jug?
Nectar?
It's the nectar!
My lord, they have taken the nectar!
Don't worry, you will get the nectar. I shall bewilder the demons by creating quarrel among them.
I want the nectar first.
Why you? I want it.
No, I want it.
Stop fighting. We'll share it.
Give it to me.
The demons work just as hard as we. They should get some too.
Never.
They don't deserve any.
Yes, they do. We should give them some.
Over my dead body we will.
To bewilder the demons and to favor the demigods, Lord Vishnu took the form of an extremely beautiful woman. This incarnation as a woman, Mohini Murti, was most pleasing to the mind because of the movements of her eyebrows as she smiled with shyness and glanced over the demons. All the demons were saturated with lusty desires, and every one of them desired to possess her.
I don't know.
I've never seen such a beauty.
Oh, beautiful one, who are you?
Please tell us your name.
My name is Mohini Murti.
Where are you from?
That's not important.
But why have you come here?
No reason, really.
Who is your father?
Does it matter?
You're obviously not married.
That's true.
Are you looking for a husband? We were just fighting over this nectar.
Nectar?
Yes, I'm wondering if you will settle the dispute for us.
Yes, please help us distribute this nectar fairly among us.
The devas are supposed to get some too.
Oh, you want me to distribute it fairly to all of you?
Please, please!
We are all brothers, but we can't seem to work together peacefully. You can help.
Oh, sons of Kashyapa Muni, I am an independent woman who finds new friends daily. And yet, you trust me to be fair?
Oh, we do, we do!
Well then, you must accept whatever I do. Do you actually trust me?
Yes, we are sure you will decide fairly.
Please, take the nectar.
Okay. Asuras, please sit here. Devas, please sit here. Look at you handsome warriors. I have never seen such powerful looking men. I was just talking to the Devas, and they are not nearly as confident and as powerful as you are.
Really?
Yes, they kept saying to me, please let us drink the nectar first. They were so nervous.
Ha! The poor things. Let them have the nectar first. We are not such wimps like they are.
Vishnu returned to his abode on the back of Garuda, but the enraged demons again declared war against the demigods. Indra fought with Bali, and other demigods like Vayu, Agni, Surya, and Chandra fought against other demons. But his many attempts to defeat Indra failed, and Bali realized that the demigods' victory was imminent. He resorted to the dark arts, creating a giant flying mountain which rained flaming trees, pikes, ferocious animals, and live coals on the demigods' heads. Feeling very much oppressed by this onslaught, the demigods surrendered again to Lord Vishnu, who then appeared and counteracted all the illusions presented by the jugglery of the demons. Heroes among the demons, such as Kalanemi, attack the world, but Lord Vishnu easily kills him. Having been graced by Sri Vishnu, the demigods began fighting the demons with renewed energy. King Indra released his thunderbolt against Bali, knocking him unconscious. When Bali fell, Jambasura and his relatives attacked Indra, but all succumbed to the power of Indra's thunderbolt. Finally, Namuchi assaulted Indra. When his thunderbolt had no effect on the demon, Indra killed him with a weapon of foam. Thus, by Vishnu's favor, the demigods were victorious.
We won!
By the grace of Lord Vishnu, we are victorious!
So good. Shosti Napriya
I envy no one, nor am I partial to anyone. I am equal to all, but whoever renders service unto me in devotion is a friend, is in me, and I am also a friend to him.
Played Lord Brahma and Vasuki, the serpent. Somarasa played a storyteller dancer and Mohini Murti.
And Harvika Prema played storyteller dancer. Haru Haridas played Rahu.
Devangan played Vayu.
Janetra played Bali Maharaj. Vibhu Chaitanya played Indra.
Mukund Hari played Varuna, Garuda, and Kurma. Preeta played a storyteller dancer and Lakshmi Devi.
Nadia Priya played Vishnu.
Yahani played Chandra. Sukha Sindhu played Kalanemi. Bal Gopal from sixth grade played Surya. He filled in for us because we actually lost our first Bali Maharaj to chicken pox. So if you could please give a round of applause to Nityananda Ram, who did a lot of work for this drama but was unable to be in it because of chicken pox. Kanjanetra filled in his role as Bali Maharaj, and Bal Gopal took Kanjanetra's role as Surya. Nitai played Agnidev. Kanai Krishna Chandra played Namuchi.
Suvarna Gorm played the demon Paka. Damodar played the demon Jambasura.
Krishna Priya played Mandara Mountain.
Haribo!
Hari Priya played Parvati. Krishna Priya played Lord Shiva and Danvantari.
Kishori played the storyteller dancer.
So this drama was, we've spent about 7 weeks on this. Started off with the study of the story from the Bhagavatam, and every event in the story is straight from Bhagavatam. I found it interesting that it's such a complex story with so many different nuances and twists and turns. There's the story of the poison and Lord Shiva saving them. There's the story of Lakshmi marrying Vishnu. She actually had a Swayambar there at the ocean of milk. So the children actually really meditated on this story day after day, week after week. They could practically think of nothing else. And if you visit their classrooms, the fourth grade classroom and the third grade classroom, you'll see that they've also drawn pictures and they've made displays of Kurma Avatar. So thank you so much to all of you for being such an incredible audience, for coming. We appreciate it so much.